In today's video, I will discuss how automation of transaction monitoring works. I will focus on the typology of transaction monitoring solutions that are now available on the market, including benefits and challenges that firms are facing when moving from a manual to an automated process. So if you are keen to learn more about transaction monitoring, you landed on the right video. But before we dive into it, if you are finding valuable my videos, make sure you subscribe to FinCrime Agent and press the thumb up on this video. This will make it super easy for you to consume new videos when going live on my channel, and it will allow me to create more contents for you. Now, with the housekeeping done, let's jump right into today's video. Hi and welcome to FinCrime Agent. This is my YouTube channel where every week I publish a new video to boost your awareness about AML and financial crime prevention. In the last couple of decades, the option of detecting illicit financial activities using manual processes instead of automated solution could have been seen as a cost-beneficial or a feasible approach to comply with anti-money laundering requirements. However, with changes to AML laws and increased regulatory requirements across most jurisdictions, the use of manual processes in AML is now the exception rather than the norm. An important aspect provided by AML-specific solutions is the level of automation that can now be achieved. However, before we drill down on how automation of transaction monitoring works, it's important to first cover some common functionalities that are kind of standards across most transaction monitoring solutions. So let's see first what is an AML TM solution. What is an AML transaction monitoring solution? AML transaction monitoring is the process of detecting suspicious financial transactions that may be indicative of money laundering. An AML transaction monitoring solution helps financial institutions detect, investigate, and often report unusual activities of their customers, generally through a processing management system, as well as using algorithms and models to spot those unusual customer activities. Those solutions are able to check all sorts of activities, including, for example, cash deposits, withdrawals, company payments, or individual bank transfers. At the back of those monitoring activities, AML TM solutions are able to generate reports and alerts to the anti-money laundering second line of defense function, in charge of detecting suspicious activities. These software applications efficiently track bank customer transactions, usually on a daily basis, and use customer history and account information to provide the big picture to bank management. More recently, AML transaction monitoring softwares allows regulated firms to also monitor customer activities in real time. These new functionalities are now making the distinction between AML transaction monitoring and fraud prevention less evident, and therefore regulated firms can benefit from a wider and more comprehensive view of the financial crime risks that are presented to their compliance investigators. We can now focus more on how automation of transaction monitoring works and see at high level where automation processes are used by most leading solutions on the market. What is automation in AML transaction monitoring? As I mentioned earlier, the use of dedicated solution in AML transaction monitoring has increased significantly over the last few years. So with those systems now in place, it's becoming the norm to see also in some shapes or forms more automation processes in place by AML teams. There are many different types of automated transaction monitoring solutions, and how the automation of transaction monitoring works can change significantly based on what the solution is designed to do. However, at high level, there are two very common types of models that have been deployed by data scientists and engineers. The first type is rule-based systems, which are programmed with certain rules that identify suspicious activities based on given criteria. These programs use predetermined rules to find unusual transactions and then flag them for review to a compliance analyst. I talked earlier about lower barriers between AML and fraud functions, so it's worth noting that when those systems are used for real-time fraud monitoring rather than AML purposes, they can also be programmed to automatically send those alerts into an automated response system to block possible fraudulent transactions and even alert a customer on their mobile or email address about the identified fraud risk. The second and more advanced model of AML TM application is based on the use of predictive models. Predictive models are designed to make predictions about future behaviors based on what has happened in the past. This type of models use machine learning, allowing advanced algorithms to watch the behavior of customers and create red flags for compliance team when there is a discrepancy between forecasts and actual events. Currently, predictive models are slowly replacing rules-based solutions, and this change can potentially take several years for a number of reasons. So in my opinion, both models will continue to survive and serve the industry in parallel for quite some time. So I hope to have cleared already some basics about how the automation of transaction monitoring works. Before we go to the next part of this video, I would love to read your comments about AML TM solutions. Are the solutions on the market able to meet the needs of the industry? Do you have a significant pain point with your current AML TM solution? Please leave your comments down below so we can open a debate with other viewers that are watching this video. So we discussed so far what is an AML TM solution and the type of models that are available on the market. We can now talk about some benefits and challenges faced by companies on those solutions. On my list of benefits, I can include the ability of banks to reduce the risk of financial crime by automating their AML transaction monitoring process. I think this is kind of a given, as with the complexity of today's market, we can no longer afford to have transaction monitoring done on spreadsheets. Second benefit is that with the automation of transaction monitoring works, financial institutions are able to gain more time on their compliance processes as a result of automating their AML transaction monitoring. The third point is from the supervisor perspective, as regulators are able to have a higher degree of confidence in the data that they receive from banks, because automated solutions inevitably follow a more structured approach, so the data shared is less likely to be inaccurate or incomplete. On my list of challenges, I'd like to include the following two areas. False positive rate. This is still a significant challenge faced by the entire industry in the AML sector. Although automated AML systems can improve the detection of risks and be more structured, false positive alerts can still generate resources and operational issues for compliance teams. The second challenging area is the reduced agility for financial institutions to update their solutions. As you can imagine, the scale of projects for the implementation of AML solutions can be quite large. Deploying an AML solution can take easily from a number of months to over a year, depending on the solution and depending also on the size of the firm. So once a solution is in place, it's definitely going to remain with the bank for a number of years. During this time, many changes can happen on the market, either as a consequence of regulatory changes or even due to new technologies that are produced and presented in the sector to better mitigate the financial crime risks. So in some cases, regardless of the awareness of better processes or solutions being available, financial institutions could still be tied to license obligations with the selected vendor. There are many other aspects that I could cover on how the automation of transaction monitoring works, like simulation detection algorithms, best practice to automate the priority of alerts, and many more, but For today's video, I'll stop here. If you want me to work on part 2 to cover more specific topics, still under the domain of how the automation of transaction monitoring works, please let me know in the comment of this video so I can do further research and expand on those subjects for you. To conclude and quickly summarize what I discussed today, AML transaction monitoring solution help regulated firms to reduce the risk of financial crime and improve the detection efficiency when compared to older manual processes. We talked about some differences between rules-based versus predictive model solutions, and lastly we learned that solutions have many benefits for banks, financial institutions, regulators and law enforcement agencies, although they also present a number of challenges that decision makers should consider when choosing a new solution provider. So with that, I am at the end of today's video. If this video was useful to you, you can show your appreciation and support my channel by subscribing to FinCrime Agent and press the thumb up on this video. Also remember to check the description of the video where you will find useful links, including how to become part of my community on patreon.com/fcagent. And lastly, thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed today's video, and until next time, see you soon.